You know, the Bible says that because Jesus was victorious, that through him, you are also victorious. And you are so loved.
Out of the mouth of a false teacher.
As you use your faith, God's going to wipe out your credit card indebtedness. It is done. In Jesus' name. Amen.
The truth is, Yahushua is the name with power. When he died for our sins, the Father resurrected him and anointed his name above all other names. That power did not transfer with the translations nor transliterations of names. The pulpits are filled with vipers spreading false truth.
So if you're a televangelist, a prosperity preacher, or a mega church pastor, then you've probably had a pretty difficult week because, you know, to your dismay, more and more people are waking up to the fact that religion is bullshit, prosperity preachers are scam artists, and more people are moving away from religion.
The religious system is a complete debacle and mockery of the kingdom of Elohim. From the beginning, mankind sought after the gods of this world and introduced them in pagan worship around the world, and it evolved over the centuries. There's your evolution.
Do not swallow anything Satan is trying to ram down your throat. Jesus comes first. Houston, and since he has a gigantic church, mind you, he could have been housing a lot of people who lost their homes. So Pat Robertson is a scam artist. He tricks believers into thinking that they'll be blessed by God if they donate their hard-earned cash to the 700 Club. So the implication here is that the 700 Club is under pressure to do more peachy keen segments, to where they say, you know, if you just give it all to God, if you donate 10% of what you earn to your church, or maybe the 700 Club, well, you might get that blessing returned to you by God. I mean, this is literally what they sell. And of course, Pat Robertson, being a businessman, running a business that is the 700 Club, he was concerned with their money.
Newspapers have flown helicopters over my house, taking pictures of my house. I didn't know how nice it was till I saw how my enemies saw it. And when I saw what they were looking at, I said, wow, I am blessed. I am blessed. I didn't know how good God had been to me. Your $1,000 cannot reproduce until it enters into a covenant with the soul. You can put that $1,000. Just the other day I like new money. I don't know if you do, but I hate old money that's wrinkled and dirty and got all the diseases on it. I like new money. And when I give things to people, I like to give stacks of money. It's fun. You ever had a stack of money? Have you? You haven't? Have you? A little. Oh.
Denying some people have prospered handsomely.
Wow!
The pastors themselves, they live like rock stars with huge mansions, private jets, and fancy cars.
Oh, yeah!
But when it comes to opulence, few religious leaders compare to Kenneth Copeland.
Amen.
Beautiful water views and comes complete with a boathouse. But that's not all. Copeland is an avid pilot, and here's his pride and joy, a $20 million Cessna Citation jet. It's the fastest private jet money can buy. He said he needed it to better serve the Lord, and proudly did a flyby for his followers after the church bought it. But it's not just one plane. We found a fleet of planes registered to the church. And you won't catch him waiting in line at the airport because he's got his own, the Kenneth Copeland Airport, located right next to his mansion.
I think Copeland is unbelievably greedy. Amen.
Repent. The kingdom of Yahweh is at hand.
Nobody gets the faithful out of their wheelchairs these days any faster than Benny Hinn. And when Pastor Benny comes to town, no civic center is big enough.
God has just healed her.
Healed her of what, Pastor?
Polio.
This woman who said she had polio and would never walk again, she and her friends say she just climbed out of her wheelchair and walked?
It's a miracle. It's a miracle.
It's unbelievable.
Pastor Benny knows it's great TV, but does he know, does he care if these healings are genuine? Anybody could make up anything.
Someday somebody's going to do that. And probably. What are you going to say then?
I don't know. I can't tell you now. It hasn't happened yet.
Oh, yes, it has. Remember that woman supposedly cured of polio? Pastor Benny knows it made for a great episode of his TV show. He knows it probably helped squeeze even bigger donations from his flock. But there's something he doesn't know.
That woman works for us. Woman doesn't have polio, never did.
Then why did you say she had?
We put her up there to see if he could tell her story was not true, to see if it would matter, to see if he would ever check. So, Benny, is it faith or is it fraud?
I'm still a human being like you. Made many mistakes, big ones, and will still make mistakes. But I really want to do better. I really want to.